What's happening, everybody? Here at the Avery, see this long name? Avery Research Center for African American History and Culture. I'm so happy to be here with my people.
My name is Erica. I'm the project archivist and the interpretation specialist at the Avery Research Center.
Peace. I'm Darren Lee Calhoun II. I run the facilities as well as public programming and outreach here at the Avery Research Center for African American History and Culture.
Cool, man. Y'all know my brother Ethan right here. Take what's up to the folks.
What's up? Y'all know me just playing games and all, being cool and whatnot.
All day. So we're going to check out some, you know what I'm saying, history and some artwork as well. Just have a good time.
Let's do it.
Syndicate the fingerprints inside the walls of the black people who built the Haven. And you see a fingerprint here.
Yeah.
Another slight one here, but the other gold print that we got, that's the most noticeable from a kid who built on the bridge.
Mm-hmm.
This is part of that project that had every day and talk about reading the
Gullah project.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Yeah. So when we're doing our programs, we always show the students, like, put your finger in there. They're about your age with how small that finger is or when they did that, when they built this building. So we always make it known that the Avery built bios for us.
Party. They can speak to the Avery student body at Charleston. far left, you boys in the middle.
That sign said, don't touch it. I'm about to touch it, too.
Yeah, like over.
Yeah.
Some of these are his images.
Mm-hmm. And what we did was mix them in with some of the Giles Allen collection, the Morningstar Singers collection that we have at the Avery already, to show how everything is the same. And we got the fishing, we got the kids playing around, and we got the singing, the swingshot, you know, Gullah Geechee Culture is a living culture. It's not something that we just talk about in the past, it's something that we still live today.
Yeah.
So we always talk about the crabbing and the rice cultivation, everything. That's everything that we do here, so Gullah Geechee Culture ain't going nowhere. I don't care what they say. Even with those bros, the bros kids.
All right, Benjamin.
I get along without you very well.
Yeah, dude. Oh my gosh, I haven't seen
it. Of course I do. Except when soft rains fall. And drip from leaves that I recall.
Oh my God.
So we usually talk about your artwork in relationship to this permanent display that we have about Denmark Vesey and the conspiracy that he had to try to overthrow slavery, and how we have documents from our archives relating to the criminal trial, and like, for example, you've got Vesey's name down here on the list as a free black man, and over here we have examples of folks who were exiled to the Caribbean and executed because of their participation in the trial. We have book titles about the Vesey conspiracy, this artist rendition of what he believed Vesey looked like, so we kind of talk about that history. And then we relate your resilience pieces to that. We usually go straight over to Robert Smalls and talk about how he self-emancipated himself and his family during the Civil War.
Maybe.
And depending on how much time we have in the background of the group that we're talking to, we might go into a little bit more depth, like talking about Mujahideen and the work that he did as an organizer in Charleston.
That's
crazy.
It's just the same.
Y'all did such a beautiful job.
It was my first time curating anything. I worked here as a graduate student like 13 years ago. I had just come back when we got back into the building. So yeah, I helped Darren put that up on the wall.
Yeah,
me and him.
Yeah, that was.
He said, "Hey man, this ain't but it's might not get up here."
Got to get it up.
To think my aching heart could kid the moon.
It was
great.
It was hitting for about 6 weeks till COVID came.
We had over 5,000 people come to the building. Like you said, the couple days before you actually sold artwork before COVID hit.
Man, you know, I actually talked about this in my thesis, man. I said how things just happen, man. You just gotta.
Yeah, you sold, what, 3-4 pieces of the Night of Charleston for the one? That's the week that COVID hit. Charleston for the one was on that Saturday.
Yep, on the 7th.
And then that Tuesday.
13th.
Yeah, airplanes shut down. Then that lady just went radio silent. We heard from her that Sunday. I think I called you that Monday after I talked with her. Then everything shut down. Then I just haven't heard from her ever since.
Food and Wine Festival. And brought in a lot of money.
I'm just glad people got to see it, man. Yeah. Honestly, that's true. Cool. I think, I forgot. This is crazy, dude. Like, I didn't care about nothing. I just care about seeing it. It's on. It's hanging somewhere, man. Mm-hmm.
People absolutely love your work, and they get caught up in this area. You know, we have about 30 minutes to an hour to do our tours, and they always just get stuck right there in that area. And they like to ask about the samurai, like how Mohini is depicted as a samurai, and Centoya Brown is depicted as a geisha. That's one of the questions that came up quite a bit. Like, why did you choose to depict them in that way?
A treat. Very, very special treat.
Word.
Appreciate Avery, you know what I'm saying? Folks at Avery for letting me, you know, come through. For real, man, it's a special treat. This is a blessing, man. I got to bring my little brother, you know what I'm saying? My other brother was on the lens, you know what I mean? But all of us have not seen this. And I just, man, this is awesome. How you feel about it, bro?
Oh, I feel fascinated by it. And this is actually one of the first times I've actually been in a new museum throughout these whole years.
Oh, man.
Keep coming back. It's always something that, it's one thing about our interpretation, you can have the same tour over and over, but you're going to get a different tour every time.
Yeah. We even took the fingerprints on the wall, man. But, all right, so let's see. All right, two people. Peace. Peace.
Nice.
What's in store?